much for your wholehearted participation again. So I'll be starting with iCoffee session now. As I told you, please start shooting me your questions from now onwards until I end a short topic on iCoffee. Well, my dear friends, today is a very important day. As you might be knowing that this is called as the World Heart Health Day. The World Heart Day, which is celebrated on 29th of September 2020 always. See, use heart for beating the cardiovascular disease. See, this is what the theme of the World Health Organization is all about, which means that you have to use your healthy heart for counteracting the other diseases which are present in the body. So this is what is called as World Heart Health Day today. See, cardiovascular diseases normally take around 17.9 million people every year. They succumb to this heart disease. So, and in fact, 29th of September every year is celebrated as the World Heart Day. So it is mainly aimed at driving people's attention towards heart illness and a range of associated heart issues. Well, there are a lot of risk factors so far as the heart issues are concerned. The first is the high blood pressure. The second is high cholesterol. The third one is high blood glucose levels or elevated blood glucose levels, which means that diabetes is one of the major disorders which is prevailing in India, is one of the most important reason for cardiovascular problems or heart diseases. That is why this World Health Day or the Heart Health Day plays a very important role for everybody, because 90% of people in India, as per one of the reports, say that they are in the early stages of diabetes, which we call this as the pre-diabetes. That is the reason why this 90% of people are vulnerable for getting heart problems in the future, my dear friends. This is a very, very important, a very caution, thing that we need to be very cautious about. Not only this, the smoking, the addictions, the unhealthy diet, the overweight and obesity, physical inactivity, all these things play a very important role in the manifestation of heart diseases. So, diabetes always has a very major relationship with the manifestation of the heart diseases, my dear friends. I hope my point is clarified to everybody. So diabetes is a starting stage which we need to curtail so that the people will not suffer from any kind of heart diseases in the future. So going ahead, friends. So the next important thing what I wanted to cover here was, as I normally tell you, the COVID-19 situation, the corona era, which is actually going on right now. Especially the people with diabetes has to be very, very careful about this particular condition of coronavirus. This is because diabetes people will always have an impaired immune system. See, normally without diabetes, the people's immune system is quite, kept upright. But with the diabetes, the immune system is always impaired. This is because the T cells as well as the macrophages which are present inside the blood, these things will always have very low, will result in a lot of immune changes within the body, because of which the impairment in the immunity will normally happen. It is more likely that many patients with diabetes in China had a poor metabolic control when infected by COVID-19. See, this is the second part of it. The first part of it is people with the diabetes normally have an impaired immune system. The second point of them, people who have already come out of COVID-19 with diabetes, their metabolic responses, especially with diabetes condition itself, is impaired, which means that people have become negative after becoming positive. Their diabetes status is also impaired now, which means that it can happen either way. So this is where the whole world is looking at the wellness supplements or the anti-diabetic supplements which can successfully, holistically control or support the blood sugar levels, so that even after the COVID-19 situation is passed out, people will not suffer from any kind of metabolic impairments, especially diabetes. I hope my point is clear to everybody. So not only this, my dear friends, I would like to tell you about one of the important articles which appeared in one of the the government websites, National Institute of Diabetes and Digestive and Kidney Diseases. They actually found out a relationship between diabetes, heart disease and stroke. See, this third point, stroke, is very, very dangerous these days. So previously there was always a history of stroke which was related to high blood pressure, stress, some kind of sudden tension, all these things cause stroke. But these days, again, diabetes is one of the major reasons for stroke, along with that you know, the low density lipoproteins or the bad cholesterol, along with triglycerides for that matter, all of them lead to this particular stroke as well, my dear friends. So having diabetes means that you are more likely to develop heart disease and a greater chance of having a heart attack or stroke. This can definitely happen whenever diabetes happens to a human being. So there is a bit of, you know, there is a relationship and interlinking between diabetes, heart disease and stroke. This is how the world is actually going around these three important things. So going ahead, my dear friends, as you all know, eye coffee. So whenever there is a, you know, there is a difference that is spoken of between our product eye coffee and the other coffees which are available in the market, one major difference stands out. See, our coffee contains the coffee beans without caffeine. Our products have caffeine-less coffee or non-caffeinated coffee. How do we get this actually? See, we source our coffee beans from the premium coffee beans from the Coorg region of Karnataka. And in fact, these coffee beans are slowly roasted for 7 to 8 hours. 7 to 8 hours of slow roasting of the coffee beans happen at 40 degrees centigrade. 40 degrees centigrade for 7 to 8 hours. This will actually cut down or eliminate the caffeine which is present in the coffee. So this is what is the most important USP you can call, the most important difference you can call between other coffees and our coffee. So that is the reason why we call our coffee as non-caffeinated coffee. Well, why I am telling you this point is one of the recent articles which appeared in one of the international magazines state that how does caffeine affect the blood sugar levels? Regular intake of caffeine will always affect your blood sugar levels. See, the research now says that people with type 2 diabetes will react to this caffeine. See how the statement is made in one of the scientific journals. People with type 2 diabetes will react to this caffeine levels because caffeine can raise the blood sugar levels and insulin levels for those with the disease, which means that sometimes hyperinsulinemia, this is what we call it as hyperinsulinemia, too much of insulin can also cause a lot of problems. See, this particular caffeine can actually increase your blood sugar levels and erratically increase the insulin levels also. So caffeine can affect how your body responds to insulin, which is also dangerous. The hormone which actually allows the sugar to enter into your cells and changes it into energy. Which, see, in a gist, if I have to tell you, this caffeine is actually causing impairment of the blood sugar levels in the body. It is also changing the levels of insulin in the body. And the second important thing is, caffeine may lower your insulin sensitivity levels also. Which means that, for example, if you have type 2 diabetes, your body already does not use the insulin well. After meals, your blood sugar raises higher than normal. This is what is called as type 2 diabetes. Caffeine, suppose if you are taking on a longer duration, may make it tougher to bring it to a healthy point. This may actually lead to high blood sugar levels. Over time, this may actually raise your chance of diabetes complications like nerve damage or heart disease also. See, people should think about this. People drinking caffeinated things, it can impair your sugar levels, it can impair your insulin levels. Third thing, it can cause complications of diabetes, mainly the heart disease and nerve damage. I hope you got my point now. Diabetes, caffeine, heart disease and stroke. All these are, you know, you can probably call them as a quadrangle. The 4 points, if you join the dots, this is how the human body will suffer from this. So going ahead, friends, as you all know that eye coffee is a wonderful product of Indus Viva. Our main USP is it's a non-caffeinated coffee. Second thing, it contains a wonderful patented extract called as salicylate, which is actually regulating the sugar levels, controlling or managing the sugar levels as well. As you all know that eye coffee creamer and eye coffee black are the two important variants which are present in eye coffee. The major difference between these two, because of the benefit of everybody, I want to tell this again. Eye coffee creamer contains the non-dairy creamer. We call this as the NDC or the non-dairy creamer. So which does not contain lactose. It is a lactose-free non-dairy creamer. So second point, eye coffee creamer contains 11% salicylate. The third point, eye coffee creamer is 15 grams in size. So far as the eye coffee black is concerned, eye coffee black does not contain the NDC or the creamer. It is not containing any creamer part. Second thing, iCoffee Black can be specifically suggested in type 1 diabetic conditions. That is one of the important things that people have to follow. Whereas iCoffee Black contains only 10 grams in it because it is not containing any creamer. Well, on either side, both of the products does not contain any kind of sugar. Even the lactose sugar is not there. I hope my points are clear to everybody. So going ahead, friends, as everyone knows, diabetes, as I told you, diabetes is related to heart disease, diabetes is related to COVID-19, diabetes is related to stroke, diabetes is related to kidney disease as well. Why I'm telling you this is diabetes is a disease or sorry, it's a disorder. You should never call it as a disease. It should be called as a disorder of multifaceted etiologies, which means that it has a hell of a lot of reasons. It doesn't have a single reason. It has many reasons. And that is the reason why nowadays the doctors are actually seeing the statistics of the people who have succumbed to COVID-19. Majority of them had this secondary complaint of diabetes, my dear friends. This is how the world is going on today. So diabetes normally happens because of impairment in the insulin levels. As I told you, caffeine is also one of the major prime factors contributing to insulin impairment as well. Well, not only this, diabetes has a lot of reasons. As I told you, the first thing is insulin resistance is one. Abnormal glucose production by the liver. See, normally the liver is called as a dustbin. Whatever we are eating day in and day out is accumulating in the liver. Liver will convert all this matter into sugar. Whenever high production of sugar happens in the liver, so automatically the blood sugar count increases. The sugar comes into the blood, which we call it as the blood sugar. So normally the blood sugar is the one which we are checking on a daily basis. So the third thing is genetic susceptibility. That also cannot be ruled out these days. So normally doctors do say these days that diabetes can happen to anybody and everybody, which is definitely true. But the family history also plays a very important role in the manifestation of diabetes. So not only this, increasing age. When the age increases, this also happens. Obesity and diabetes are also two faces of a coin, my dear friends. Well, somebody is diabetes, they can definitely and certainly develop obesity symptoms. When someone is obese, they can certainly develop the diabetes symptoms. This can happen either way. Bad diet also plays a role. Pre-diabetes is also one major reason where the whole country is suffering from today. Nearly 90% of the people in India are having this pre-diabetes problem. That is what the doctors are actually saying. Well, we have a wonderful advantage with us. We have a wonderful product with us called as iCoffee Creamer and iCoffee Black, which are considered as elixirs for this pre-diabetic condition, so that we can certainly prevent people from entering into type 2 diabetes stages. I hope my point is clear to everybody. So going ahead, friends, diabetes is actually called as India's bitter truth, which means that today India is called as the diabetic capital of the world. By 2040, it is an estimate that more than 100% of people in India can be diabetic, which means that the diabetic count can increase like anything. I'm not trying to talk about an exaggeration here, which means that it can go beyond the limits. That is how it is. It can see, it is not a spreading disease. It is not an epidemic or a pandemic, but it can happen to anybody and everybody, as doctors say. So, but definitely we have a wonderful product with us, iCoffee, which is a holistic wellness supplement, which can certainly help us in limiting or regulating the sugar levels in a healthy way, so that the people or the masses who are consuming this can certainly have relief from their diabetic complications as well. Well, talking about the diabetic complications, as I told you, my dear friends, COVID-19 these days, the most of the recent publications or the clinical trials which are happening across the world, they are stating that because of this COVID-19, diabetic complications are increasing like anything. The complications might be in the eyes, which we call it as the diabetic retinopathy. The complications might be in the nerves, which we call it as diabetic neuropathy. The complications might be in the kidneys, which we call it as diabetic nephropathy. So the fourth complication has also come into the world today called as diabetic enteropathy, which is nothing but the complications which happen in the intestines. This is how the complications of diabetes are actually causing problems to the people. Even not today, my dear friends, tomorrow we might have another bacterial or viral attack. Definitely diabetes is one such disease which will stand out and definitely tell people that I am here before any other viral disease affects the body, which means that along with the virus, this can dance to its tunes and automatically it can cause a lot of secondary complications as well. Well, the most important ingredient which is present in iCoffee Creamer and iCoffee Black, as I have told you, is a Salicylia reticulata. We call this Salicylia reticulata as Ekanayakam or Saptaranga. So in fact, Salicylia reticulata, we have taken a patented extract from this plant called as Salcital. Salcital is normally extracted from the roots of Salicylia reticulata, and this is known for controlling or managing the diabetes levels. And this is known for about 900 to 700 BC from the period of Ayurveda. So known for maintaining or, you know, controlling the blood sugar levels. So going ahead, friends, it also contains the goodness of coffee beans as well as the Mucuna pruriens, which we call this as the velvet bean herbal extract as well. So both these ingredients are known for managing or controlling the sugar levels. Well, coffee beans as well as Mucuna pruriens, both for that matter, will control or manage the sugar levels. So there are a lot of articles which emphasize the goodness of Salicylia reticulata in managing the blood glucose levels. In fact, there are a lot of animal experiments as well as the clinical trials also. In one of the clinical trials, one of the recent clinical trials, we have seen that this Salicylia markedly, it decreased the digestion and absorption of blood glucose or the sucrose by its inhibitory action on the sugars, and then reduces the increased blood glucose levels and insulin levels as well. Which means that Salicylia reticulata is definitely important for managing or controlling the blood sugar levels without causing serious adverse effects. This is what the importance of clinical trials also are, my dear friends. Which means that it regulates the blood sugar levels without causing any problems or side effects or adverse effects. This is how Salicylia reticulata is actually proven today as one of the important ingredients in iCoffee, which can manage your sugar levels without any side effects, without any harsh side effects. That is the reason why we normally tell that you can manage your sugar levels without worrying much about the side effects, without compromising the authentic taste of your coffee, my dear friends. This is what is all about Salicylia reticulata. Not only this, the other important specialty ingredient that is present in iCoffee is called as the Mucuna pruriens. Well, these are actually called as a specialty ingredients. See, normally there are local ingredients also, but there are some ingredients which are used in the product called as specialty ingredients, which are special by nature. As the name indicates, they are special by nature. One such ingredient is called as the Mucuna pruriens. We call this as the velvet bean extract also. This particular velvet bean is a wonderful ingredient for managing the increased blood sugar levels in the human body. It supports healthy blood glucose levels. It manages the blood sugar levels also. In fact, Mucuna pruriens seeds have a very good results on the structural changes in the pancreas and liver through its anti-diabetic and antioxidant properties, my dear friends. I hope you got my point clear. Pancreas is the organ which contains these beta cells, which produces this insulin. So this Mucuna pruriens or velvet beans directly has the activity on this pancreas, which will regulate the blood sugar levels, and also has a wonderful activity on the liver, which cleanses the liver, which detoxifies the liver because of its antioxidant attributes. So whenever the liver is detoxified, whenever the pancreas are detoxified, automatically the sugar levels are maintained inside the human body. I hope the point is clear. This is how the Salicylia, the Mucuna and the coffee beans, which are present in this iCoffee, is helping the human being to control the blood sugar levels. Well, as you all know that iCoffee Black can be certainly used for managing type 1 kind of diabetes, whereas type 2 kind of diabetes can be managed by the use of iCoffee Creamer as well. Not only this, both of the products does not contain any kind of sugar in this. It can be taken as long as desired, but as a part of wellness supplement, I would suggest you to take at least for a minimum period of 3 months. It can be taken safely along with other medications as well as insulin also. As I told you, even the recent clinical trials are actually mentioning that this Salcital or Salicylia reticulata is a wonderful natural ingredient which can suppress or control the sugar levels without causing much side effects or adverse effects. So it does not lower the sugar, so you don't have to worry about the hypoglycemic situations like normally the other diabetics normally do. The hypoglycemia will not happen in this. You don't have to worry about lowering the sugar fast. It can lower the sugar very gradually as well. So it can be taken by a normal person as well. When a normal person is consuming iCoffee, I would suggest you to consume one sachet in a day. Either it is one sachet in a day or half sachet twice daily also can be consumed, half an hour before the breakfast and half an hour before the dinner as well. So this is how a normal person can use iCoffee. Along with this, my dear friends, you should always use one sachet of iCoffee with 80 to 100 ml of warm water or hot water. Never use cold water with iCoffee, because these actives, whatever I told you, the ingredients, it might be the Salicylia, it might be the coffee beans, it might be the mucuna pruriens or the velvet beans, the solubility, the absorbability of these ingredients in cold water is not much. So definitely if you use warm water or hot water, the efficacy or the palatability of the product also increases a lot. I hope the points are clear to you. With this, let us all consume iCoffee without compromising the authentic taste of coffee, my dear friends. Thank you so much, Vivites, for watching this wonderful Facebook Live again. So as I told today, so please do use these terminologies, use these concepts in your daily retailing and promotion as well. So I spoke about the caffeine today. I spoke about the relationship between diabetes, stroke, heart disease, as well as liver disease and kidney disease also. I also spoke about the ingredients of iCoffee, especially the specialty ingredients, the mucuna pruriens or the velvet beans. All these things you can inculcate, habituate in your daily, you know, the promotions as well as the prospecting, so that people will understand how exactly this wellness product is holistically acting in the body to control or maintain or manage the blood sugar levels. Thank you so much, Vivites, for your patient participation. So now it is a question answer time. I would like to answer your questions which have been come to me today. So let me take up some of the questions which were asked last week as well. One more thing before I take up the questions, I would also like to tell you that there is a link which is appearing at the bottom of the chat box. So please do, you know, click the link. Whenever you click the link, there will be a, you know, a window which opens. Please do pose your questions there. Our team will be very happy to answer each and every of your questions. Thank you so much, Vivites, for that. So let me take up the questions now. The first question is by Mr. Jiju Varghese. If you're watching this, is there any drug-to-drug interactions if someone uses iGlow, iWave and iCoffee together? Absolutely no, my dear friend, because these are all natural and wellness-based products. You don't have to worry about the drug-to-drug interactions. Don't have to worry about it. Screen is from Mr. Sai Kumar. If Mr. Sai Kumar is watching this, one customer reports before iCoffee it was 190 and 290. After using it for 2 months, the levels have reached to 290 and 400. So what is to be told for this patient? Mr. Sai Kumar, if you are watching this, you have to consume one sachet of iCoffee in the afternoon and one sachet in the night, half an hour before lunch and half an hour before dinner. Please stop iCoffee in the morning times. If you do this, definitely the controlling of the sugar levels will happen. The next question is by Mr. Deepthi Beda. If you are watching this, type 1 diabetes, how to use iCoffee Black? Sorry. So in case of type 1 diabetes, iCoffee Black should be used in the same way. One sachet in the morning, half an hour before breakfast, and one sachet in the night, half an hour before dinner. This is the same way that you can use it. The next question is by Mr. Joshi Panikkal. How long type 1 diabetes should consume iCoffee Black? It should be minimum for a period of 3 months. The next question is by Mr. Jisha Varghese. After consuming iCoffee, blood sugar levels are high. What would be the reason? As I told you, suppose after the consumption of iCoffee creamer or black, if the blood sugars are high, please follow this rule. Morning you should stop using iCoffee, afternoon it should be one sachet and night one sachet, half an hour before lunch and half an hour before dinner. If you stop it in the morning times, definitely the controlling or managing of the sugars will happen. So the next question that I am seeing here, does iCoffee has chlorogenic acid, by Mr. Rampal? Yes, it contains the natural ingredient called as chlorogenic acid. In one of the other Facebook lives, I will be speaking about this. So the next question is by Mr. Rajiv Rai. So after consuming iCoffee, the urine smells like coffee. What problem it is? Mr. Rajiv Rai, don't worry about it. It is absolutely natural. It is absolutely natural, not only with coffee, even sometimes with ginger, sometimes with garlic, the urine and feces will have the same smell. So you don't have to worry about that. It is an absolute normal process which happens in the body. So the next question that I am seeing here is by Mr. Rina Paul. Okay, I hope, yeah. The next question that I am here seeing here is by Mr. Deepak Sinha. A patient is 35 years old, suffering from sugar. His pancreas has 50% damage. Can iCoffee and iPulse regrow his pancreas? Can insulin levels can be normalized? So Mr. Deepak Sinha, if you are watching this, You can definitely suggest him iCoffee Black and iPulse. iCoffee Black will be one sachet in the morning and one sachet in the night, half an hour before breakfast and half an hour before dinner. iPulse will be 20 ml in the morning and 20 ml in the night. So far as regrowing of the pancreas, we don't assure you anything. But antioxidant activities of these ingredients have many research papers and studies showing that the regularizing of the sugar can happen with this particular ingredients and the product as well. The next question is by Mr. Arvind Agape, if you are seeing this. After consuming iCoffee, sugar has increased. Can we suggest iCoffee to the same customers? Suppose, Mr. Arvind Agape, if you are seeing this, suppose if someone's sugar increases after the intake of iCoffee, ask them to stop iCoffee in the morning times. Ask them to consume one iCoffee in the afternoon, half an hour before lunch, and one in the night, half an hour before dinner. If you do this process, the controlling or managing of the sugar will happen. The next question is by Mr. The next question, what I am seeing here, one of my customer is suffering from diabetes and her leg is having wound. I would definitely suggest you to consume iCoffee Black in this condition, one in the morning and one in the night, half an hour before breakfast and half an hour before dinner. The next question is by Mr. Kalyan. If you are watching this, fast results of weight loss with iSlim, which product should be suggested? I hope this, along with iSlim, you can definitely use iCoffee. Why I am telling you this is, both iSlim and iCoffee contain salicylate. It is for this purpose only. As I told even in my speech, even in my lecture now, suppose if someone is diabetic, they can definitely have symptoms of obesity. Suppose if someone is obese, they can definitely have the symptoms of diabetes. That is the reason why, Mr. Kalyan, you can definitely provide iCoffee creamer and iSlim together. iCoffee creamer will be one in the morning and one in the night, half an hour before food. I hope my point is clear to you. So the next question is, one of my customer has diabetes. I suggest him to consume iCoffee. After consuming, the blood sugar has increased. I hope the answer I've given it before. You should stop iCoffee in the mornings, one sachet in the afternoon, half an hour before lunch, one sachet in the night, half an hour before dinner. I hope the point is clear. When you stop it in the mornings, automatically the blood sugar levels are also regulated. So the next question is by Miss Elvina Nazareth. Is iCoffee helpful in cyst or PCOD problem? Yes, very important question. You can give it along with a combination of iPulse and iCoffee both. iCoffee will be half in the morning and half in the night, half an hour before breakfast and half an hour before dinner, whereas iPulse will be 30 ml twice daily. So next question is by Ms. Manjula. Can a normal person take iCoffee creamer? How many before or after food? You can definitely take, that is one sachet in the morning. You can make it half two times also, half in the morning and half in the night, or one sachet per day, half an hour before food. You are taking half twice daily means half in the morning before breakfast and half in the night before dinner. It can be taken for a minimum of 3 months. So the next question is by Mr. Deep Sharma. As per your suggestion, I have given black coffee for weight loss for 40-year-old lady. She is getting heel pain. What can I do? Mr. Deep Sharma, please continue the same dosage. The pains can happen in diabetes. This we call it as diabetic neuropathy. After some days, at least after 1 month of giving this, automatically the pains will subside. I hope the point is clear to you. Please continue in the same dosage. The next question is by Mr. Elvira D'Souza. If you are watching, if your person is having high BP and sugar, then iCoffee should be taken before or after. It has to be taken half an hour before food only. It should not be even taken after food. For the benefit of everybody, iCoffee should not be taken after the food. It should be taken before food only for better solubility and absorption. I hope my point is clear to everybody. So thank you, Vivites, for posing your wonderful queries. As I told you, there is a link which is appearing below the chat box. Please do click the link and pose your questions, so we will be happy to answer them as well. Thank you so much, Vivites. So for watching this wonderful Facebook Live series called as Ask the Doctor, we wholeheartedly appreciate your participation in this series for making it successful. Thank you so much. This is Dr. Balu Kolar signing off from the desk. Have a nice day ahead.